It's funny how South Africans feel that they will use insecurity in Nigeria, according to them, the insecurity in Nigeria, to laugh at us or to say things that are not real. Now, you're saying we should go and fix Nigeria and leave South Africa alone, or Boko Haram and all of those things. Well, let me read some of the comments on this comment section and I will get back to saying my own sense. This person said, them no year say Davido sang them go feel it, meaning that the South Africans are now the ones crying when they know that they started this whole thing, so they will feel it. This person said, South Africa had learned the hard way. Exactly. And you see, where people don't understand things, they begin to make assumptions. This person say, if Bolt ban Nigerians' account, we too go stop using Bolt. There are many caps in the country. No need for, you know, Bolt safe. That's the truth. So what Bolt is trying to say now is that people, South Africans, are pushing that Bolt should ban Nigerians. Hey, you don't even know. Without Nigeria, see, go to the whole world, eh? The people that patronize Bolt, if you remove maybe America or maybe UK. In short, Nigerians are the ones who even patronize them more. Go and do your findings. Do your findings. Go around and do your findings before you come for us. Come correct. This one said, we are hooked watching what is happening between Nigeria and Dundee Republic, aka South Africa. You see, the thing is, South Africans don't even know who they are toying with. They don't even know half of who they are toying with. This person said, me, I ordered 3 gas cooker in 7 Michelin tire and 7 Michelin tires. You can imagine. So a lot of people also who are on this comment section, who are on social media, they are ordering these things. They are quiet too, but they are doing the ordering too, because you can't come to people. You destabilize our own people's business and you expect us to clap for your own people. No, it's not done that way. This person said, South Africans, you are encouraging Nigerians to turn South Africa economy upside down, right? Exactly, because you are the one who is looking, crying now. But you're the same person that came for us and you expect that we'll not turn your economy upside down. We can do it in a split second. If you don't know it today. Another person said they did well by retaliating. Otherwise, next time they will do worse things. They will never try Nigerians on cyber war, else they would cripple their economy. See, South Africans don't even understand how powerful Nigerians are. They do not, because I'm sure if they did, like I saw other countries telling them, Unafono tried this thing, like they shouldn't have even tried it in the first place. If they knew half of how Nigerians, if Nigerians want to come for you, they come for you without mercy. Because see, do you know the kind of things we've survived as Nigerians? And you think that your little squabbles will get at us? No, 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 it will not. This person says, Jacinta is crazy. She's spot on the South African accent. Yes, a lot of Nigerians have, you know, tried to use South African accent. I've seen them on viral videos. But one Jacinta tried to do her own and it was really, really funny. It's been trending. People have been laughing at it. I think even on TikTok, it's there. People are laughing at Lee, like she's really sounding like, trying to sound like them. And you see, I have made my videos without even trying to sound like South Africans, because if I do, it's not a funny thing. This thing we are saying is not funny. And that person says, small minds all over. They're really small minds, because it's only small minds that discuss people, right? Great minds discuss invention and other things, how to, you know, move the world forward. And that person said that a lot of things make South Africans worry about Nigerians. And that's the truth. A lot of things. South Africans never see anything. Oh, them go see. Them go hear them. Like, you see, on this comment section, it's just that because of YouTube guidelines, I'm trying not to put up so many things here. That's why you see that some I will read it or some I'll talk about it. Just, you know, get used to that because of YouTube guidelines. And that person said, if people are free in Nigeria, why are they scattered everywhere in the world causing trouble? Oh, no. See, people don't even understand. Nigerians are not people who stay one place. Let me make you understand. Nigerians believe that traveling is part of learning, and which is true. Nigerians read a lot of books. They read books. A Nigerian can live in Nigeria through reading books, have known what is going on in other countries. Do you understand? That is how Nigerians are. Nigerians don't need to be in your country to know much about you, because you read a lot. It's just recently that Nigerians stopped reading, or most Nigerians stopped reading. Nigerians can stay here and know what's going on in Singapore, know what is going on in the educational sector in Singapore, know what is going on in Australia, know what is going on in Canada, know what is going on in the United States of America. They know these things. Do you understand? You see this thing, this milk you are watching, all the all are made from farm produce in Nigeria. You talk about our health sector. This place you are seeing is a clinic in Nigeria. It's a clinic, a private ward in Nigeria, a clinic. So, and somebody, an individual owns it. An individual owns this place you are seeing. So I don't understand why you think that Nigerians can be compared. This food you are seeing, it's just for one person to eat. It's loaded with vegetables, you know, stew, other things, plantain. And you think Nigerians are broke or Nigerians are hungry? According to you, Nigerians are not hungry. It's so unfortunate that you don't even know. Nigerians are not hungry. They are not hungry. The fact that they came to your country is because they want to learn about your country. They want to stay there. Nigerians are not people that... Even I made a video where I talked about how people build mansions in their villages in Nigeria. If it comes to even hair business, check out Nigeria. See their hair. They are into hair business and they are doing it 100%. It comes to Ghanaian eggs and, you know, everything. We have different meals that are very healthy. All the meals I've shown you guys on this channel are just healthy 100%, and all farm produce. So you think we cannot do without you? No, we can do without you excellently. So before you come for us, come correct. Do not even try it. You're asking why Nigerians are traveling. Hey, so we should stay in our own country and not know what is going on in other country. No, we will travel to know. We will not listen to your lies. We will travel to know so that we'll be able to know when you are telling us the truth and when you are lying. That is why that's who we are as Nigerians. We do our grilling ourselves. We have our local grills and all of that. We don't need you people. We have our, you know, artificial lakes. We have our artificial lakes. You can see the ship, the pontoon and all of that on the artificial lake, and we are doing just fine. We are doing just fine. So I'm showing you all of this so that you know this lake you are seeing is artificial. And it's called the Jabi Lake, and it's situated in Abuja, Nigeria. We have the normal canoes, we have the pontoons, we have the ship and all of that here in Nigeria. So there's nothing you think you have that we don't have. We have houses, we have buildings that we give at, you know, people rent to own. So before you come, you see, we have great edifices that you'll be wondering. See our hospitals. These hospitals you are seeing are all owned by individuals and they are all Nigerians. Please, Black South Africans, show me what you own. You said on the comment section that you are the shareholders. You have shares in how do you call that place? You have shares in ShopRite. I'm laughing at you. Like, because you have shares, we should do what now? We should break our head. I'm showing you private hospitals. All these hospitals you are seeing are private clinics, not government, owned by Nigerians. Owned by Nigeria. We don't even need any foreigner to come to Nigeria to establish. Yes, we don't. We are not sorry. We don't need. Because you guys feel that without you, we can't survive. Haba now. When we have, you know, shopping complex. See, before ShopRite even came to Nigeria, we've always had shops, big malls. Those of you who know Sahad Plaza, Sahad Stores, what are you talking about? Sahad Stores is owned by a Nigerian. So you think that without you guys, we cannot survive? Hey, yeah, please, people should wake up from sleep. Wake up, wake up, wake up. Wake up from your sleep. Wake up from your sleep. Oh, get up from that sleep and don't even sleep, because Nigerians are very, very hardworking people. They don't need you to survive. They do not need you at all to survive. So when next you're coming for Nigerians, come correct. Come with your full information. Come with your full chest. Do you understand? So you said Nigerians like to travel. Yes, we like to travel because we like to learn about other people. We don't like to remain. That is why a lot of South Africans are very timid, because they don't travel. They don't know what's going on. And if at all they travel, they come to the places and they feel comfortable. But when people come to their place, they do not feel comfortable around the people because of low self-esteem. Why are people fighting Nigerians? Because Nigerians are very ambitious, and those people who are fighting them have inferiority complex, because they know that Nigerians, being in their country, they are going to outshine them. Yes, they know they are going to outshine them. That's what is paining them. This person say, look, seriously, South Africans are really funny. They just wake up one morning and decide to look for trouble, and of people that said their New Year slang is, we know they grieve for anybody. Exactly. Their New Year slang this year, Nigerians woke up and said they know they grieve for anybody. And then you think you come for them and you expect them to stay mute and watch you do all your shenanigans? No, we won't let that. We wouldn't like that because we know our onions. Like I've told you in a previous video, we know our onions. Your companies are already begging. Your own companies are already begging. They say Nigerians should please calm down. Yes, we will calm down, though, because we are peaceful people. But do not come for us and expect us to fold our hands. It's just like beating a baby and trying to tell the baby how to cry. No, we don't believe in that. You beat us, we will cry and teach you how to treat us. We will cry and teach you how to treat us. You don't try that with us. This one said the South African posted the prank himself. He's posted it for the world to see. The South African posted the prank himself. He posted for the world to see. Most things have been happening outside Africa. And then recently there's something that happened to in South Africa that BBC has been carrying. I'm trying to follow that news very well to see how I'll bring it on here. Let's see how they will say it's a lie, because these are documentaries. You cannot fault such documentaries because they are very, very, you know, correct. They are very, very correct. And you see, South Africans rely on Nigerians for a whole lot of things. When it comes to prayers, it's our pastors they listen to. If it comes to, you know, entertainment, it's our music they listen to. How many South Africans have, you know, done hit songs that people will say, oh, they have, apart from the other girl that sang, what's that song she sang that even make me swear, those songs. You see, when it comes to Afrobeat songs, come to Nigeria. Come to Nigeria. We are the Baba. Of course, you know our musicians are always topping the chart. Go to any industry. Our artists are usually topping the chart when it comes to acting. Why do they hold the AMVCAs in Lagos? Please go and find out why. Before you come for Nigerians, go and find out why the AMVCAs are being held in Nigeria. Go and find out why everything is about Nigeria. A lot of our stars go to South Africans and they get ill treatment. You don't treat them well, but you come to Nigeria and you live large. See, Nigeria is a free man town. Like, in Nigeria, you live freely. People don't attack you unnecessarily. People don't just... Because we love... See, I don't blame some of you, Sha, who are coming to the comment section to talk about how that we have a Boko Haram, we have the insecurity and all of those, we should go and fix it. I don't blame you. It's because of how our print media, our social media, most of our Nigerians are very gullible. Who travel with some of them have never even been to Abuja, some of them have never been to Lagos, some of them have never been to Port Harcourt, and all they do is stay in their village and come out and then travel to South Africa or Ghana, and then they begin to compare Nigerians to you. Or compare the Nigerian, you know, economy and situation to you. See, if you want to crumble your economy, we can do it in a split second. So be careful. Nigerians are not smiling. They've told you guys that if you don't take it, if you're not careful, they'll bring down your economy. And they can do it. Nigerians hold your economy. You don't know. You don't even know. You see, Nigerians are just, oh my God. This one say, if you slap someone and the person decides to slap you back, you cannot say how hard the slap back compared to how you had slapped the person will be. Nigerian did the right thing. You see this cyber war that is ongoing. One day you people will sit down and truly apologize to Nigerians. Because without Nigerians, South Africans, go and ask your president. Without Nigerians, you can't survive. That's the truth. You can't survive without Nigerians. You are talking about other African countries. Nigerians should pack and go to other African countries. Let me tell you the truth. Any African country who is fighting Nigeria already know why. Because people have serious complex issues. Nigerians are in... I've never seen Americans say they want to send Nigerians back. I've never seen... United Kingdom saying they want to send Nigerians back. I have never seen Canadians say they want to send Nigerians back. It's usually African countries who are having serious complex problems, who are feeling that the reason that they are not making it is because Nigerians are in their country. And it's so sad. It's so sad to be listening to people talk like that. Such a myopic way of reasoning. Like, you think that you are mocking us for insecurity. Let me tell you one thing about the insecurity in Nigeria. A lot of insecurity news you listen to are politically motivated. Let me tell you, because somebody wants to get into power, the person comes up with some kind of stunt, and then people feel that we are having security issues. No, that's not the point. And you see, good, the whole world, eh? Nigerian police are the best. Like, they know their onions. They know how to tackle insecurity. But, you know, when it is politically motivated, the interests of people, like, there's conflicting, this conflict in interest. I don't even know how to put it the right way. So you understand. But when it comes to, have you found out how many awards the Nigerian security, that's the police, I'm not even talking about the military, the police have won when they go for peacekeeping? Check it out. Please always read. The problem with you South Africans is you don't read, so you don't know all these things. When it comes to peacekeeping, Nigerian police officers are the best. When it comes to investigating, the Nigerian police officers are the best. If they want to come for you, they will know. So you cannot say, you cannot mock Nigerians with insecurity. You cannot mock Nigerians with Boko Haram, because we know our onions. We know what we are doing. Boko Haram, as it were, is politically motivated. You don't know. If you don't know that, know it. And that is why I tell you, don't just listen to news. Read up on certain things, the history of people. Today, most companies, you say, yes, they are leaving Nigeria. Why are they leaving Nigeria? Because of government policies. And it's not because Nigeria itself is bad. And if they have another government that will do policies that they will be comfortable with, they will be coming back here. There are so many companies that have been in Nigeria for over 50 years. Some have been in Nigeria for over 60 years, some 80 years. You don't know. Even before Nigeria got her independence, they've been in Nigeria. And when Nigeria got their independence, they've still been in Nigeria and they've never left. You want me to begin to mention those companies for you so that you go check it out? Do you understand? So it's so sad how they feel they can just talk to us anyhow. This was to say, there's no day that goes by without Nigerians talking about South Africans. Just focus on fixing your Nigeria. We are fixing our own country. We don't care about Nigeria. South Africans, who told you you don't care about Nigeria? It's so sad. I pity you people, because you do care about Nigerians. You do care. You care so much about Nigeria. You care. Oh. So people are saying, this person said, make no mistake about it. Ghana started the incitement of hate against Nigeria. Even now, if you want to be famous in Ghana, just make a video criticizing or attacking Nigeria. Cameroon will pick it up, up the hate. Then South Africa. Exactly. That is what they do. All these African countries, they cannot make videos without us. Because they know that once they mention Nigeria, the video will go. So they come for us. Because all of you are in the scheme of things. Who know you now? All these African countries, who know you? In the scheme of things, you are not important. Nigerians are the giant of Africa. That thing can pain you people. Eh? That's why you are fighting us. We are the giant of Africa. We stay the giant. We remain the giant, and nothing can change it. We remain the giant of Africa forever and ever. Yes. Somebody said it's just a nickname. I love them. I don't understand how 50 million people will come and be competing with 200 million people, over 200 million people. I mean, like, make it make sense. Make it make sense. Share people say you are crazy. We will teach you how we used to cure crazy people. Yes. Nigerians will teach you how we used to cure crazy people. You cannot try that with us. This one says South Africans cannot win this Nigerians interwar. They cannot win. Yes, South Africans will never win. They can never win the drama. It's not possible for them to win the drama. You understand? This was say, all I know is South Africans can't play with Nigeria. No internet war. South Africans too small. They're too small now. They're not rich. They're not rich. On a regular, they're not rich. Do you understand? You are mocking us with insecurity. It's sad. It's really sad. This was say, Nigerians come all out. Okay? No one know what's involved in the shit. See, Nigerians will come out because this whole madness has to stop. Do you understand? This whole madness has to stop. You cannot. A lot of people, Nigerians came for them and began to order different things from their place. See how beautiful Nigeria is. Look at, you people should look at Nigeria. I've shown you, this is not even the best of Nigeria, but look how beautiful, clean, you know, Nigeria is. Green, everywhere looking sparkling. And you think you can wake up one morning to disrespect us? No. We can't take it. We can't take that sitting down. We cannot. A lot of Lebanese have companies here. You see that company you saw there? All those places, most of them. You see, by the time, you see DSTV, they know already. They've been sending us messages begging now. DSTV has been sending us messages begging that we should please subscribe. Because they'll come up and hike the prices of their subscription, putting Nigerians at, in a very tight place. And Nigerians woke up and said, no, we are not subscribing anymore. Because Nigerians, anyway, most times I blame Nigerians for leaving their own indigenous companies to patronize all these foreign companies who do not have respect for their own citizens. Because if they did respect us, they would not do certain things they are doing. You discover that the economy is going somehow, is going south because of bad government policies. And then you come up with your own increment. Like every October, they made it a point of duty to increase. Do you understand? Somebody is saying that whatever Nigerians have done in South Africa, making people to spend their hard-earned money, that they are going to pay. How are they going to pay? South Africans will pay for everything, because when you look for trouble, you will pay for the consequences of the trouble you've looked for. You cannot come for us and expect us to sit down and fold our arms watching you disrespect us. No. You saw the thing we did. We said that Nigerians started ordering from restaurants, television, you know, stations and all of those things. So they're ordering for things that were pay on delivery. And at the end of the day, you saw the aftermath of that. Next time, do not try Nigerians, not come for us. Because if you come for us, the outcome will not be palatable. Of course, you know. You know Nigerians never back down. When they are in their right, they never back down. So please go and find out about Nigeria. Find out from people who are older in your country. In case you do not have elders, find out from your president. Can you imagine?